Hello there, and welcome to this video. Let's see how to make a complete DVD interface with Pinnacle Studio 20. Leave a comment inside the video description to improve our future video guides for Pinnacle Studio. Pinnacle Studio is able to create interactive DVD menus, complete with buttons used to browse inside a DVD or a disc content. You can create and edit DVD menus by using the Author tab on top. Let's suppose to have a project complete. When you switch to the Author mode, Pinnacle asks you to convert your movie or video project to a disc project. A disc project is a video project that includes DVD menus and all their objects. Respect to the edit workspace, you still have the AV tracks where your project is placed, but also an additional track on top called Menu List, visible when the DVD menu icon is enabled more on the left. Let's see how to create a working DVD menu for the actual project. A DVD interface is composed by several pages called menus, used to browse through the video content inside the DVD. And each menu contains objects which can be text, backgrounds, geometrical shapes, and also special objects called buttons used to connect a DVD menu with another menu or with a chapter of your video project. From the navigation panel, if you go to Content and then to Disk Menus, you can see several ready menu templates available inside Pinnacle Studio. For each single template, you have two kinds of menus, one used to introduce the DVD content in order to play back all or choose any chapter, the other to select which chapter to play back. You can check the appearance of each menu by checking the preview under Source Mode. To import a menu onto your project, just drag and drop it on the Menu List track. The preview under the Author tab still shows the timeline mode used to play back your DVD video content, but also the new menu mode used to simulate the menu and its objects as it should work when playing the DVD. When you click on the play button below, you open the disk simulator where you can interact with all the objects and the buttons inside the menu by using the DVD simulation in the lower right corner to simulate a remote control. At first, the imported menus may have buttons completely hidden, since these do not link to any menu or chapter. By default, only the Play Movie button works correctly. Let's see how to make these buttons work. To edit a menu, select it from the timeline, and then switch the preview to the menu mode. This will right show its buttons, which are linked nowhere at first, as their red color suggests. For example, the Scene Selection button should be linked to the menu that brings to all the video chapters. If you click on its own down arrow, you can choose the menu to link to it from the direct list. If you choose Menu 2, this button will show M2 and get the same color of such menu. When you simulate the interface and click on Scene Selection, this will bring to Menu 2. On the timeline, the Menu 2 thumbnail won't have any red icon after getting at least one link, indicating that such menu is no more isolated. If you have non-connected menus, you can delete them by right-clicking on these. Buttons can link a menu with another menu, but also with parts of the video project called chapters. For example, the Play Movie button links to the beginning of your video project. But when you switch to Menu 2, you still miss links to chapters inside your video project. The list inside the buttons include menus only. To insert links on the video project, you have to work with the project timeline below. Right below the preview, you have several buttons used for chapters. Select the interested menu and choose the right button from the list on the right by using the left and the right arrows or by clicking on it directly on the menu on the preview. Then, just place the playhead at the beginning of the video and click on Create Link. This creates a chapter link called C1, indicated by a simple marker right below the menu list track, and with the same color of the menu that contains it. This appears also inside the button on the preview. When you simulate the DVD interface and click on a chapter, you will play back your project right from that point, exactly where the chapter link is placed. Also, the chapter link comes with another marker at the end of the video called Return. When you reach this point, the DVD interface brings you back to the latest menu page indicated on the marker itself. Keep in mind that when you select another menu, all the chapter links related to the previous menu are disabled. When links are established, the raw numbers are substituted by video thumbnails picked where the marker is placed. But if you want to change this thumbnail, place the playhead correctly and then click on Set Thumbnail. All these markers indicate the fixed instance of time to follow. You can click and drag these to move them in time. To delete a chapter link, just click on its marker and go to Remove Chapter on top. Let's see how to edit the appearance of your menus. Starting from a ready template, you may want to edit the chapter names or add the missing buttons on Main, Prev, and Next. When you double-click on a menu, the disk editor opens, composed by a timeline below, that shows all the objects contained inside the menu, the navigation panel on the left, and several properties and settings on the right. As you can see below, all buttons are indicated by green rows and are composed by several objects, such as text and geometrical shapes. To edit a chapter name, just click on its piece of text and type in. To edit a button, just click on its thumbnail and open the button settings on the right. Through the first bar, choose the kind of button between Normal, Previous, to link to the previous menu page. Next, for the following one, and Not a Button, to remove any link. More below, choose the button color when it is selected and when it is enabled. Choose Set as Default to make such button selected when entering the menu, and Still Thumbnail to use a fixed thumbnail that does not move. Even more, you can use the text settings and the look settings sections to edit the text appearance. Choose a different filling color or add effects such as outlines and shadow. To know more about how to edit and apply these effects, check out the dedicated video in this guide. More below. The background settings is used to fix any background or soundtrack inside the whole menu. To add a picture or a video on the background, you can drag and drop a file on the thumbnail shown. To add a soundtrack, just drag and drop a sound file on the audio drop zone. Make sure that there is no audio on the video to use for the background. Also, this kind of menu shows the ready buttons for the Main, Prev, and Next. But these are not ready to receive links yet. To make them active, just select them from the preview and choose Normal as button type. When you go to OK below, you will apply all your modifications and the button becomes active, as you can see from the preview in the menu mode. Once both the DVD interface and the video are ready, go to Export right above the preview. The Studio Exporter will open on the Disk section. Set Type and Preset under Settings, simulate and playback your DVD content on the preview, and check all space and device information below. At the very bottom, you have several options. Choose Create Image to render the whole DVD content as an image, or choose Burn Disk to render your whole DVD project on your disk, ready for a playback. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and free video guides on several professional software.